Our next topic is movement along the demand curve. That is also known as change in quantity demanded. What is the meaning of change in quantity demanded? Whenever we are talking about change in quantity demanded, that is due to change in own price of a commodity. When quantity demanded of a commodity changes due to change its own price, keeping other factor remaining constant. As other factor means when the price of related goods, income of the consumer, taste, preference, all these things are constant, only change in own price of a commodity. That is known as change in quantity demanded. It may be that quantity, it may be upward movement or it may be downward movement. Whenever the curve upward movement, when price rise, then quantity fall. If price is rise and quantity is fall, that is called upward movement. And downward movement means when price fall, quantity demanded increase, that is called upward sloping. See this diagram. On OX axis we have to show the quantity and OY axis we have to show the price. Initial price is P, then we have to demanded Q units. This is our A point. Now, if the price is rise from P to P1, when price is increased from P to P1, quantity is increased Q to Q1. It means quantity increase, that is an upward movement. That is an upward movement at the point B. Same as if price is P2, then quantity demanded is from Q to Q2. This is a C point. Here, this is a downward movement. When price falls and quantity demanded rise, this is a downward movement. This upward movement and downward movement is known as expansion in demand and the contraction in demand. What is the meaning of expansion in demand? Expansion in demand means a rise in the quantity demanded due to fall in rise in quantity demanded due to fall in price of a commodity. Other factor remaining constant. Let us see price and quantity. If price is 20 rupees, we have to purchase 100 units. But whenever the price is reduced 15 rupees, we will take more units. So this is called extension of demand from 100 to 150 units. Let us take how we can draw this diagram. On OX axis, we have to draw the price. On OY axis, we have to draw the price. And OX axis, we will take demand. Is 20 rupees. Let us see, this is 20. When price is 20 rupees, we have to demanding 100 units. Let us see, this is 100. So, at a price of 20 rupees, we are demanding 100 units. This is our point A. Now, if price is 4, 20 to 15 units, then our demand is increased. That is known as due to change in this price, this much demand will be increased. Now we have to move the point from A to B. Here quantity demanded is more. It means that is known as extension of demand. We will call it extension of demand when we have to move from point A to B. Second point, contraction of demand. Contraction means a fall in quantity demanded due to rise in price of a commodity, other factor remaining constant. Let us take example, if the price in the market, that is 20 rupees, and we have to demand it 100 units, but now the prices will increase. Now we are demanding less unit. So from 100 to 70, the unit is reduced. That is known as contraction of demand. We will see the diagram. Same as on y-axis, we will show the quantity, and OY will show the price. When quantity is 20, when price is 20, suppose this is a 20, then quantity demanded is 100 units. This is a 100 units. This is our point A. Now price is increased from 20 to 25. Now we are demanding less. Now we are coming to the point B point. From A to B, due to rise in price, we have to demanding less unit. From point A to B, this is known as contraction of demand. That is from A to B. Here from A to B, that is known as expansion of demand. From B to A, A to B, this is known as contraction of demand. So movement along this movement is only on the same curve. That's why we are saying that movement along a demand curve. Here quantity is changed due to change in own price of a commodity. Next is shift in demand curve. Shift in demand curve is also known as change in demand. Change in demand, when demand of a commodity changes due to change in any other factor, other than the price of own commodity, it is known as change in demand. Change in demand, there are so many reasons. Suppose the income of the consumer is changed. Suppose the price of substitute goods or complementary goods change. Taste and preferences change. Distribution of income is changed. Expectation is changed. All these factors affected to the demand, then the demand curve will be shifted. The demand curve will be shifted rightward shifting and the leftward shifting. Demand rise at the same price. See, in this diagram, if demand, whenever the price is P, demand is Q. Price is constant, demand is increased from Q to Q1. Price is constant, then demand is increased to Q to Q1. So from point A to B, that is known as rightward sloping. This is a rightward sloping. Same as price is constant, the demand is from Q to Q2. That is Q2. Point C. This is a point B. From A to C, this is a leftward shifting. Falling demand at the same price, it leads to leftward shifting the demand curve. See in this diagram. This rightward and leftward shifting, the name is given increase in demand and the decrease in demand. This rightward shifting is known as increase in demand. This leftward shifting demand is known as decrease in demand. Let us see increase in demand. Increase in demand refers to rise in demand of a commodity due to change in other factors other than the price of a own commodity. See, here price is constant. Whenever the price is 20 rupees, we are demanding 100 units. Again, price is 20 rupees. Now we are demanding 150 units. How it can be possible? Maybe our income is increased. That's why we are changing our demand. So, how we can draw these? On OY axis, we will show the price. And OX axis, we have to show the quantity demanded. price is 20. Suppose this is 20. The unit demanded is 100 units. It's 100. Now, this is our point A. Now, price is constant, demand is increased. Suppose demand is 150. Now, price is constant. At a constant price, we are demanding more units. We come to the point at B. This rightward shifting of demand curve from A to B, this is known as increase in demand. This is known as increase in demand. Same as decrease in demand. Decrease in demand refers to fall in demand. Fall in demand of a commodity due to change in other factors, price will not be changed. Let us see this example. On OX axis, we have to show the quantity. On OY, you will show the price. Whenever the price is 20, we are demanding 100 units. This is our point. Whenever demand is 20, we are demanding 100 units. So this is our point A. This is